So students, let us continue with the next topic, that is experiment demonstrating the existence of two kinds of charges. Two kind of charges means positive charge and negative charge. First of all, what we have to do, just suspend this rubber rod with an insulating thread. This is a rubber rod and it is suspended with a thread. Now, one end of this rod, rubber rod, is rubbed with fur. This end is rubbed with the fur, and then rub one end of another rubber rod with fur, and then bring this rubber rod to this suspended rubber rod. You will observe that the suspended rubber rods will get repelled from this rubber rod. So here we can conclude that two rubber rods rubbed with fur repel each others when brought near each others, because both are getting the same charges, and same charges repel each others, because the ends of these two rubber rod is rubbed with the same thing, that is fur. So both the end acquire the same charge. When these two rods brought near to each others, they get repelled. So in the next experiment, again this is a glass rod and it is suspended with the help of thread. Again, rubbed one end of this glass rod with the silk, and take another glass rod and rubbed its end with the silk only. Again, you will find that when this rod will brought to near to this rod, it will get repelled, because both the ends of the rod get positive charge, means like charges repel each others. Now the third experiment is there. Again, suspend a rubber rod with an insulating thread. Now one end of the rubber rod is rubbed with the fur, and rub one end of the another glass rod with the silk. Now this is different from these two. Its end is rubbed with the fur and its end is rubbed with the silk, and bring this end of the glass rod near the rubber end of the suspended rubber rod. You will observe that the suspended rubber rod turns toward the glass rod. Means what happens? Means this rubber rod, which is rubbed with the fur, acquired negative charge and it acquired positive charge, and like charges attract each others. Clear? So these are the three experiments. So this I have already explained to you. These are the same charges, they will repel each others. These are the same charges, they will repel each others. These are the different charges and they will attract each others. Charges, note down, charges of same sign is that either all positive charge or all negative charge are known as like charges. Charges of opposite signs are known as unlike charges. Now the next topic is conductor and insulator. Students, we have studied in the previous classes also that conductor means which can conduct the electricity. ठीक है, the material which allow flow of electric charge through them easily are called conductors because they are having a free electrons in them or mobile charges in them. So once again, conductors conduct electricity because they are having a free electrons in them, or you can say they are known as mobile charges. Mobile charges means free electrons. They can move anywhere inside the conductors. Like few examples are given, silver, copper means all the metals are good conductor of electricity. Then insulators are the materials which do not conduct electricity or which do not allow the electric charge to flow through them because they are having a very less free electrons in them. Because they are having a very less free electrons in them. So that are known as insulators. Insulators, examples, glass, rubber, plastic, paraffin, PVC, ठीक है, polyvinyl chloride, the full form of PVC is polyvinyl chloride, then nylon, porcelain, dry wood, etc. are the example of insulators. Now note is given, under ordinary condition, no substance is a perfect conductor or perfect insulators. Now the next topic is very very important topic, that is gold leaf electroscope. Now what is gold leaf electroscope? It is a device used to detect the presence and the nature of electric charge on a body is known as electroscope. Once again, gold leaf electroscope is a device used to detect the presence and nature of electric charge on a body is known as electroscope. Now, first of all, this is the diagram of electroscope. This is a very sensitive and commonly used type of such apparatus. It is mostly used in the lab. First of all, it consists of, this is metallic disc. This is the metallic disc. Metallic disc means this disc is made up of metals. Then this metallic disc is attached with the cork. This is cork. Then a very thin foil of gold about 5 cm length is folded in the middle and is attached to the lower end of the metallic rod. This is the metallic rod and these are the gold foil whose length is 5 centimeter. Clear? Now the two parts of the gold foil from the gold leaves of the electroscope. The electroscope is housed in a metallic case having glass windows with the earthing socket. Glass window with the earthing socket. Clear? These are the gold leaf. this is a metallic bottle, this is a metallic rod, and this is a cork, and this is a metallic disc, and here it is a glass earthing soft. Clear? Now what is the working of this? What is the working of the gold leaf electroscope? First of all, detection and amount of electric charge. First of all, what we have to see, divergence of the two halves of the gold leaf of electroscope shows the presence of electric charge on the gold leaf. Divergence means how much it's repelled or attracted. Clear? So they will tell that the presence of electric charge on the gold leaf. When this gold leaf electroscope is charged, what will happen? The divergence between these two leaves will increase or decrease. So let's see. First of all, when a charged body, say a glass rod rubbed with a piece of silk cloth, is touched with the metallic disc of the electroscope, you can say, you can take one glass rod like this and just touch it with this. Now we know that glass rod is positively charged, ye positively charged hoti hai. Clear? When this glass rod is touched with the metallic disc of the electroscope, the charge is transferred to the gold leaf through the metallic rod. Charge transferred to this gold leaf. Both the leaf of the electroscope acquired same type of charge. They will also get the same type of charge, so they repel each other, hence the gold leaf diverges. They will get the same charge, and what happens? They will diverge. Their divergence will increase. So the distance between these diverge half of the gold leaf depends upon the quantity or amount of electric charge on the leaf. If the quantity or amount of electric charge on the leaf is large, the divergence will be more, and if it is small, then the divergence of the leaf is also small. Then in this case we have detected the charge and the amount of electric charge on the electroscope. Now the next is nature of electric charge. Nature means positive or negative. When a charged body is touched with an already charged electroscope, suppose this is charged and this electroscope is already charged. Electroscope is also charged and the metallic body is also charged. Now when a charged body is touched with the already charged electroscope, what will happen? There will be two cases. One, the two halves of the gold leaf converges if the charge on the charged body is opposite sign to that of charge on the electroscope. Means, suppose this glass rod is positively charged and the electroscope is negatively charged. This is negatively charged. So what happens? These two leaf will converge. They will come together because it is a positively charged and this is a negatively charged. So what happens? They will converge. Then the two halves of the leaf electrode diverge further if the charge on the charged body is same sign. They will diverge if the electroscope is positively charged. If negatively charged, what happens? They will converge and if positively charged, what happens? They will die worse. So like this, this gold leaf electroscope works. Clear? Then methods of charging and induction. Method of charging and inductions. In the next video, we will do method of charging and inductions. Thank you.